action here on the round three. This is the second hole. Round three of the TKG Tour underway. JJ's left with a little bit of a tester here for par on the second hole, par 5. Oh, nice par putt, par save. I mean, that par 5 hole 2 just made that hole look way harder than it had to be. Just so important that you do not put your second shot right, because these overhanging trees will just take you right out of the mix for birdie, which is why I had to play a punch shot out of those trees there, because left side looks a little bit narrow and intimidating, so if you let it get to the right, you're not going to be able to have a clear shot at the green. You're going to have to play that little punch shot like JJ played there. And well, these greens are slow and grabby and sticky sometimes, so with these grainy greens, sometimes it's hard to get the ball all the way up to the pin. But nice par. It's always good to get one of those putts to drop early on in the round. And we can move on. Start to get some rhythm here and see if we can go low. This is the third hole. Par 4, big sweeping dog leg to the left, right to left. JJ is taking off a huge chunk of this hole by going over these trees here. Not sure with that extra look there. We'll have to head up there and see. See if JJ can get the ball down the left side. This time, it's better than the morning round. indicated by the quick tee pickup, but I lost it. Just a little bit too much there. He's got himself a little bit of a hairy lie here in the bunker with some wet sand. Let's see if he can roll out, but doesn't look like it. Not dropping. It's a good putt, but not dropping. So here is JJ again, same spot as this morning, hole 6, par 5, just waiting for the green to clear, and this is green light for JJ in the 3 wood, see if he can get a little bit better strike on it than the morning, get it to fly a little straighter. All right, JJ with a nice little pitch, a couple feet from the hole. Let's see if we can convert this little big putt here. All right, okay, so that erases that tough bogey from a couple holes ago. Bounce back. Birdies hole 6. Watch out for the downhill down greens. You know, the greens are a little bit slower than what he's used to. But then all of a sudden, there's that one downhill down green putt catches you out every single time. Just gotta watch out for that one. So here we are, hole 9. Halfway through the third round. She absolutely stripes that one. Okay, so one birdie, one bogey in the third round. JJ is sitting at 8 under for the tournament. Needs to make something happen here to go to double digits under. JJ is sitting in the rough there, just ahead of those trees. He shouldn't have anything obstructing him. He should have a clear shot at the green here. Let's see what he's gonna do. Ooh. Kinda just got hung there. There's actually two big ridges there. But he didn't catch it. He actually caught the flat part. So, no rip back, and from the rough, so not too much spin. So, JJ with the birdie putt here. See if he can finish the first 9 holes of his third round. 1 under. Get this one a drop.
No.
Oh, just ran out of speed kind of there under the hole. Oh, Okay, one birdie, one bogey, even par. First nine of the third round. Final nine holes of the TKG Junior Golf Tournament, WAGA ranking, World Amateur Golf Ranking, Junior Golf Scoreboard, here at Cappenbury Sport Club. Kids are playing the 27-hole format. 27 holes, 27 Whoa. Holes. That one's going left. We'll see where that one ends up. Let's see if JJ can capitalize on his good bounce here. Kicked off the tree just right to there. Ooh, no rip back. Probably because the lie was in the rough there, so just a little bit over the flag. No rip back. Oh, that's harsh. Great little downhill putt there. You had the speed just perfectly dialed in there. So good start to the last nine holes of the day, but definitely pushing for a little bit more action. One bogey, one birdie only. So far, that's just not normally like him, so we'll see. It's just so nice to be back recording JJ's golf tournaments again. As previously said, JJ's been on the Thai national team since qualifying in December, and he's been real busy just with those commitments and attending the camps, and we haven't been able to record anything when he goes to the camps, so he's kind of got a little bit of a break from that. And there you go, nice shot, JJ. So he's got a little bit of a break from the Thai camps. They've already completed four camps so far this year, and the fifth camp was canceled because they have the Southeast Asia Games on right now, and a couple of the more senior members of the Thai national team are in Cambodia training and practicing for the SEA Games. So they canceled the fifth camp, which we immediately took advantage of and signed up for this tournament, where JJ can compete for WAGA World Amateur Golf Ranking points. At the same time, we can also get Hazel, JJ's younger sister, into a golf tournament in the 7 and 8 division. So it's definitely a win for the parents, because we get to come to one tournament and two kids can play. So absolutely love this format. 27 holes, 2 days. It's exactly what we really like this tour for the format, especially in the rankings. And it's just so nice to be back documenting JJ's golf tournaments, and hopefully we can get a couple more in later on this month while I'm home from work. It all lines up, and you know, we got the Singha Thailand amateur match play coming up too later on this month. That's always an exciting tournament. See if JJ can convert this birdie putt. So we've got some cows on the loose over here. Coming on to the golf course and disrupting play. That's okay. Somebody's gonna have to come and get their cows. Too many cows on the loose. JJ was able to convert the birdie, and the cows have been found by their owner and returned back to the bush. JJ cuts the corner there a little bit. This par 5. So JJ hit a really nice second shot there. So he's got a little bit of a pitch shot here. Let's see if he can make it happen. Get this one nice and tight. For the birdie, but yeah, for sure wanted to be a little bit tighter than that, but looks like it's pin high at least. Push that one. That's not good, but a bit of a missed opportunity there. I thought that was going to be breaking, but didn't actually break at all. Super grainy little patch there. It's got a light patch and a dark patch, so a little bit of grain. Probably didn't work out the way that he wanted or was expecting. JJ's going to go for the green again here. About 280 yards to be safely on the green, 270 to the water's edge. It takes about 280 to be safely on the green, and maybe the flag is about 285. It's an aggressive play, but it's definitely an eagle to be had if you can hit the green. Body language is a club twirl. Well, I heard a ball land, but I don't see it, so should be okay though. So JJ just ended up greenside there, just in a little bit of a depression. Couldn't see it, I guess, but he was there safely. This is an eagle chip. Didn't drop. That's okay. So the aggressive play paid off today. You know. Okay, so 2 under for the third round so far, and 10 under for the tournament. I think that's what he wanted there. So JJ mentioned that he had a little bit of a funny lie there in the middle of the fairway. That's why the ball kind of squeezed out low to the right. But anyways, here he's got a chance to drain this putt anyways. It's a little bit uphill and into the green. So a slow putt. We'll see if he can get the speed right. Oh, and he got the speed right. It was just dying right at the end there. I was worried. That's all right, so. Yeah, from a bad lie in the middle of the fairway to a birdie. That's how you do it. So, 3 under for today's round and 11 under for the tournament so far. So JJ has to be careful here. This is the 15th hole. This is a sharp dogleg to the left. Takes about 310 yards carry. He wanted to cut the corner into the wind. So JJ's just laying up here with a 3-wood. Looks okay. Was left a lot. Let's see if JJ can get up and down for bogey here. After the referee came to help him drop the ball properly. Is that that green bush over there on the left is a hazard with a red line. It's always good to have the referees because they actually teach the kids the right way to drop the ball and figure it out properly, right? Okay, good up and down bogey. Move on to the next. Let's see if we can get it too. Okay, JJ with a par 3. He's got an iron in hand. Seems looking good. There you go. That's how you come back. Nice draw. Nothing wrong with the mechanics there. Just a little bit of a misread on the last iron shot there. Wind was coming right to left and played a draw right into the bush. So JJ with an opportunity to get that shot back with a 2. Likes this putt a lot. I think it's moving left to right, just barely uphill. Great looking putt. Ooh. That sucks. Didn't break at all, or just gave it too much line, pulled it maybe. Okay. That's fine. Par 5, hole 17. Ooh, that was left. Let's see, that's okay. AJ's start line and finish line are two different things here. Must have played a big sweeping high cut there because the ball started flush and ended up in the middle of the fairway. Now he's got a green lane for a 3-wood par 5. Flustered from missing a birdie putt after a bogey. Yeah, he needs to be able to get over that pretty quickly, because being flustered and having gyrations after every single golf shot doesn't actually help. Scientifically proven not to help. So JJ's second shot is just fine, but obviously just wasn't happy with the contact, because you know, yesterday he was on it too, and he's about 35, 40 yards off of the green today, so just played a little bit too much cut on both the driver and the 3-wood. It's got to roll. So he's got some work to do for birdie. It's a long day, trying to finish quickly, not happy, so it is what it is. Definitely an underwhelming par there, but par's a par. Move on to the 18th, and one more chance to get back your drop shot there. Pretty straightforward par 4. JJ managed to punch onto the green, but he's going to have quite a long putt for birdie. But nonetheless, it was a good punch out. Just going with a little bit too much cut here at the end of the day. Obviously, the wind is also going from left to right. So a cut, you have to, you know, play that. But usually when frustrated or nervous, always goes to the comfortable cut, but you know, overdoes it and doesn't take the line down the left as much as he should. So last putt of the day, last hole. Downhill. Let's see if JJ's got speed for this one. Drain it or lag it right up beside the hole. Obviously they had the wrong line there, but hole high. So for par. /70 for the third round, so 2 under. For a 10 under total, so a win is a win. Congratulations, JJ, on a great 54-hole tournament here at the Kapanburi Sport Club in Thailand. And that's all. So we'll see what's coming up next on the schedule. Things are a little bit messy and a little bit undecided at the moment, but definitely have a lot of opportunities coming up. And looking forward to recording some more of JJ's tournaments.